There's three things that plague the auto industry. The first one is ignorance. The second one is a toss-up between pride and ego. And the third one is just straight-up greed. Let's talk about them. Welcome to the Master Tech Lou channel. I am Lou, a self-proclaimed master technician, because I know I will never know all there is to know about automobiles. I'm willing to adapt and learn, and that's what I want to teach you guys here in this channel. I have a perfect example of ignorance in this vehicle behind me, a 2009 Chevy Impala. Let me explain to you what happened. Customer had two things they noticed. One, the smell of exhaust and the sound of exhaust when they started up in the morning. Two, they had an airbag light on the dash. Here's what the two different shops thought they found. For the exhaust noise, both shops said the same thing. Flex pipe. They all do it. It's the flex pipe. One shop quoted $1,200, the other shop quoted $1,800. Here's where ignorance comes into play. No one looked at the flex pipe. It took me 25 minutes to find where the air was leaking, and it blew my mind. Here's the gasket. Here's the exhaust port. Here's the bolts that mount the exhaust manifold to the cylinder head. And here's where it was leaking on all three areas. Long story short, the engine I have is a 3.9 liter Chevy V6, federal emissions. The cylinder head that's on the car is for a 3.5 liter with California emissions, so there's extra holes drilled for the exhaust ports for the air injection system. That's where it was leaking from. Now you're saying, Lou, why are you yelling? Because this infuriates me. When I tell people I'm a mechanic, you know what they say? Or what they think, or what I think they think? Oh, so you're a liar, you're a cheater, and you're a scam artist, right? You just wanna take my money and do whatever you want. I'm trying to change the stereotype of the mechanic. We're not all bad. It's ignorant ones like these that just say, give me a cylinder head for a V6 and slap it on and let her ride without double checking their work before it leaves the shop. How did I find the exhaust leak? I took a hose. You ready to laugh? I took a hose. I put it in my ear and I have a stethoscope on the other end that when I blow into it, you can hear the noise. We'll see if the microphone can pick it up. I'm going to put it by the microphone and I'm going to blow into it. Then while the car is running, I go to the exhaust and I plug it. Now the exhaust has no choice but to come out of wherever it's leaking. The reason it took me so long to find the noise, because it wasn't making sense. First, I found four of the six bolts were loose. Once I tightened them, I thought it would have sealed it up, but it did not. Then I thought if the exhaust is loose, it will actually burn the gasket because it's getting hot where it shouldn't get hot. And I thought maybe it was just a burned gasket. When I pulled it out and seen the track marks as to where the exhaust was actually coming out of, it made no sense. Then I went to the parts catalog, looked up what the cylinder head looks like. Then I went to the cylinder head. Then I found a part number. Then I went back to the part number and searched for the part number. And that's when I found out it was for the wrong car. The shops that diagnosed it were ignorant because they did not do their homework and look at the failure. They just said, oh, all Chevys have flex pipe issues. It's got to be the flex pipe. So what would have happened was the customer would have paid for the repair. It wouldn't have fixed it. Then they would have charged the customer. Well, now you have another leak. Oh, of course you have another leak. Why would it be your fault, right? Which falls under category number two, pride and ego. After the first shop said flex pipe, my buddy who sold these people the car says, it doesn't sound like a flex pipe. I know what a flex pipe sounds like. It sounds more like an exhaust manifold leak. I've been in the car world for 20 years. I know what these things kind of sound like. So I took it to another shop. They had it in the shop for 10, 20 minutes and I'm like, yeah, flex pipe. It just doesn't make sense, but go ahead and put the flex pipe on if it needs it. With the pride and ego, when he asked the second shop, hey, I don't think it's right. They just said, no, that's right. And refused to go further. So here I am. Here's what I found. What did I do different? All I did was verify the actual point of failure without assuming, because I don't have the pride or ego to say, I know everything's right. You're going to do what I want to do because I'm the mechanic and you're just the customer. Oh, that angers me so much. On to number two. The airbag light was on. They scanned the codes, and the code was for the seat belt buckle pretensioner. What that means is when you get into a crash, an ignition is made, and an explosion happens, and the cable pulls the buckle tight, so it tightens your seatbelt so that way you can't go forward to the airbag. Chevy has two of them, one on the actual seat belt and one on the actual seat belt anchor. The issue was with the anchor connection. The shop wanted to sell the customer a seat belt. What would have happened was they would have put the seat belt in and it wouldn't have fixed it. And guess what? Now you have another problem. I hate the term, it fixed it 50%. It fixed it 60%. Now you have another issue. No, you misdiagnosed it and you're the problem with my car now. How did I determine they were wrong? Because the wording is in the code. It's on the screen right here. They wanted to sell a seat belt retractor when the issue was the seat belt anchor pretensioner. It's in the wording. Let's talk about greed real quick. Mechanics get paid by what we do. Every job has a time amount assigned to it. Starters can pay an hour, starters can pay 6 hours. If we get a 6 hour job done in 4 hours, we made the commission of the 2 extra hours, okay?
If we get the job done in 10 hours, we only get paid the 6 hours. Ideally, that's usually what happens in shops. But what else can happen is a time that's given to us that says the job takes 2 hours, but I can never get that done in 2 hours, then we're gonna charge a little bit extra because we know it takes and it takes longer, and for some reason, the job is wrong. But here's where greed comes into play. Mechanics don't get paid by the hour, they get paid by the job. So if you start making more hours than you're actually working, that extra money is a plus. So what do all mechanics do? I'm sorry, I don't mean all. Don't want to anger you. What do most mechanics do? They go buy motorcycles, jet skis, more tools, more tools, more tools. They go get a rental house, a cabin, a vacation spot. They want to go out on the weekends, or they become drinkers. They find reasons to spend the money. Now you have a lifestyle that you have to live up to. Now winter time hits, it's Christmas time. Nobody wants to put money into the car because they didn't account for the car repairs. They want to spend money on Christmas stuff for their presents, for their kids, for their mothers, for their grandmothers, for their husbands, for their wives, who knows for what, right? But you've got to make that extra money because you have bills you got to pay. So you know what? I'll find something wrong with the car. Let's sell an extra transmission flush. Let's sell an air filter. Sure, I normally wouldn't sell this, but I have to make that money, Lou. I've got to have that paycheck. These are things that happen in the car world, okay? The reasons customers dislike us is because you have ego, you have pride, you don't want to listen to the customer, you don't want to do your diligence in verifying the repair, you care too much about money. Money doesn't make you happy, more stuff doesn't make you happy, man. I've been there. I've made $50,000 in the car world, I've made $100,000 in the car world. I was never happier with the money. I was happy knowing that some mother got her kids to soccer practice, or some dad didn't have to take off a day off of work to bring his car in and lose a paycheck and pay for repairs because we talked over the phone for a few minutes and his issue was normal. There's so many good scenarios out there, but people only want to focus on the bad stuff, man. Change mentality of people. Be a better mechanic.